For that, first we need to know what is NDFA and DFA. In DFA, for each input symbol, one can determine the state to which the machine will move. Hence, it is called deterministic automaton. As it has a finite number of states, the machine is called deterministic finite machine or deterministic finite automata. In DFA, there is only one path for specific input from the current state to the next state. DFA does not accept the null move. That means that DFA cannot change state without any input character. In this following diagram, we can see that from state A, for input 1, there is only one path which is going to B. Similarly, from B, there is only one path for input 0 going to the final state. So we can say that it is a DFA. We can represent DFA by a 5 tuple, Q, sigma, delta, Q naught, and F. Where Q is a finite set of states, and in this picture the states are A, B, and C. Sigma is a finite set of symbols called the alphabet, in this image which is 0 and 1. Delta is the transition function from one state to another. That means the current state for a single input, the machine can go to a single state only. And Q naught is the initial state from where any input is processed. And in this diagram, it is state A. And F is a set of final state or states of Q, in this picture, which is state C. Now, what is NDFA? In NDFA, for a particular input symbol, the machine can move to any combination of states in the machine. In other words, the exact state to which the machine moves cannot be determined. Hence, it is called non-deterministic automata. As it has finite number of states, the machine is called non-deterministic finite machine or non-deterministic finite automata. NFA has two exceptions. It contains multiple mixed states and it contains e-transitions. In this following image, we can see that from state A for input 0, there are two mixed states, B and A itself. Similarly, from B for input 1, the mixed states are C and A. Thus, it is not fixed or determined that with a particular input where to go next. Hence, this FA is called non-deterministic finite automata. An NDFA can also be represented by a 5 tuple Q, sigma, delta, Q naught, and F. Where Q is finite state of states in this diagram, which are A, B, and C. Sigma is a finite set of symbols called the alphabets. In this case, which are 0 and 1. Sigma is the transition function from where the current state Q for an input symbol, it can go to multiple next states. Here the power set of Q has been taken because in case of NDFA, from a state, transition can occur to any combination of Q states. Q naught is the initial state from where any input is processed. And F is a set of final state or states of Q. Every NFA is not DFA, but each NFA can be translated to a certain DFA. Now we'll come to the conversion of NDFA to DFA. Here in this example, we can see that from state 1, Q1, on getting input 0, it can remain in the Q1 state or can go to the Q2 state as well. So we can tell this is not a DFA. We'll first make the transition table for this diagram. So there are three states, Q1, Q2, and Q3. Q1, Q0, Q1, and Q2. As Q0 is the initial state, it is indicated by an arrow. And as Q2 is the final state, it is indicated by a star. Now, when the current state is Q0, for the input 0, it remains in the state Q0. And for the input 1, it goes to the state Q1. Now, when the current state is Q1 for input 0, it can remain in the same state or can go to the final state Q2. So we'll write them in a bracket. And for the input 1, it can go to the state Q1. Now, when the current state is Q2, for the input 0, it remains in the same state. And for the input 1, it goes both to the stage Q1 and Q2. Now, we'll convert this to a DFA. For that, we need to obtain the delta transition for each state. So, delta transition of Q0 on 0 is Q0 and Q0 on 1 is Q1. The delta transition for the state Q1 on 0 is Q1 Q2. We will consider it as a new state generated, and Q1 on 1 is Q1. The delta transition for state Q2 on 0 is Q2 and on 1 is again Q1 and Q2. Now we will obtain the delta transition for the new generated state Q1 and Q2. Q1, Q2 on 0 is the union of Q1 on 0 and Q2 on 0, which is Q1, Q2 union Q2 equals to Q1, Q2. And Q1, Q2 on 1 is the union of Q1 on 1 and Q2 on 1, which is Q1 union Q1 Q2 equals to Q1 and Q2. Now we'll add the new state Q1 Q2 in the transition table. And previously only Q2 was the final state, but now Q1 and Q2 will also be the final state because it contains the final state Q2. Now this will be the final diagram according to the transition table. And we can see that it is a deterministic finite automata. Now, conversion of NFA with E transaction to DFA. As NDFA permits empty string transition, for that we use null move, which is E closure. E closure for a given state A means a set of states which can be reached from the state A with only E move, including the state A itself. So here it is an example of NFA with E closure, while Q0 is the initial state and Q4 is the final state. So first of all, we obtain the E closure for each state. E closure for Q0 is a set of Q0, Q1 and Q2. E closure of Q1 is Q1. E closure for Q2 is Q2, E closure for Q3 is Q3, and similarly E closure for Q4 is Q4. Now we will take the E closure for the starting state of NFA as the starting state of the DFA. So let's consider E closure of Q0 be the initial state A, and delta transition of A on 0 is E closure of Q1, Q2, Q3 on 0. Which also means E closure of Q1 on 0 union Q2 on 0 union Q3 on 0. As Q0 on 0 and Q2 on 0 is null, thus the result will be Q1 on 0, which goes to the state Q3. So E closure of Q3 is Q3. We'll name it as state B. Similarly, delta transition of A on 1 is equal to E closure of Q0 on 1 union Q2 on 1 union Q3 on 1, resulting to the E closure of Q3, which is Q3. So we can see from state A, on getting input 0, it goes to the state B, and from B, on getting input 1, it goes to the state A. So our partial DFA diagram will be this. And now coming to state B, delta transition for state B on 0 is E closure of Q3 on 0, which is null. And delta transition for B on input 1 is E closure of Q3 on 1, equals to E closure of Q4, which is Q4. Let's consider the state Q4 as state C. Now for the state C, delta transition for C on both 0 and 1 is null as it is the final state. So our final DFA diagram will be this. With this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you, sir, for your guidance.
Very good presentation.